Hey everybody, we are here playing a little more Ace Combat 7. Time to fly. Let's see what kind of trouble we can get into. I forgot what mission we were on. Okay, we stopped here. I don't think we tried the mission. This is the Cape Rainy assault.
With the loss of an arsenal turret, followed by the destruction of their ballistic missile base, Jerusha is running out of ways to counter. This is a great opportunity for the Ocean Army to bolster our power to eventually take down the Erusian capital of Farbanti. The special long-range strategy is entering its final phase. Our objective is to attack and capture the Erusian Air Force Base in Cape Rainy in northern Erusian. This important base is...
Oh, yes, I did try this a few times, and this sucked.
Under the cover of night, our plan is that all squadrons will invade the valley to the...
Oh, we're flying in a canyon.
The enemy's observation field has eyes on the skies above the valley. Your altitude will need to be restricted. If you go over a certain altitude, the enemy could spot you, ending the mission in failure. Keep that in mind. Once you arrive, you are to take out the enemy's air defense forces as soon as possible and prepare for the support squadrons. When the air defense forces are neutralized, the helicopter squadron should arrive carrying Marines. The plan is to take control of the base. Getting through the valley is only half the job.
Okay.
Strider Squadron, aircraft prep complete. You're cleared to taxi.
Beginning nighttime aerial refueling process. Be careful of reduced visibility.
If you can hear her, my daughter is playing something. No problem.
Strider 1, you have passed through waypoint 1. No weapons until you reach the enemy base. All aircraft, reduce altitude. We have altitude restrictions from here on out. Keep altitude below 600 meters. Good. Maintain your current course.
Okay, altitude's got to stay under 600. It's basically the ridge of the canyon.
Searchlight up ahead. Watch for it.
Stay out of their sight.
Safe. I'm worried you're short on men. Everyone here's already signed their wounds. That ain't funny.
Never was good at jokes.
Okay,
four.
about to get narrower. Be careful.
Watch your speed.
Caution. Caution. Pull up.
You passed waypoint 3. You're coming up on the base. Imposing radio sirens.
Oh, darn it.
Strutter 1 crashed.
Your speed.
Shoot! How? How do you get through that? Do I have to slow down? That doesn't make any sense.
Strider 1, you have passed through waypoint 1. No weapons until you reach the enemy base. All aircraft, reduce altitude. We have altitude restrictions from here on out. Keep altitude below 600 meters. Good. Maintain your current course.
To a base at the end of this canyon. But I have to stay in the canyon and under 600.
Watch for it. Stay out of their sight.
Huh? I can't hear you.
We'll get you down safe. I'm worried you're short on men.
Waypoint 3. You're coming up on the base. Imposing radio silence. We won't be able to talk again until you're over the base. Continue to keep an eye on your altitude. There are plenty of dark spots that can sneak up on you.
Caution. Pull up.
Well, that was the answer. Just don't get spotted by any of these spotlights. Holy cow. I got this.
Be quick. On time, means three. Good jokes. established on the airbase. Reach destination.
Commence the attack. It's time for their wake-up call. The longer it takes, the worse off we'll be. Hurry up. Finish them off.
All right, let's give them a beating.
Oh, I couldn't see. That was very sudden. That's a bummer too, because I was really good run. All right. Whew.
Confirmation on the airbase. Reach destination.
Commence the attack. It's time for their wake-up call. The longer it takes, the worse off we'll be. Hurry up. Finish them off.
All right, let's give the beating.
Vehicle eliminated. Target acquired.
Strider 1, you've got their attention.
Squadron. It must be the reinforcements they called in.
I'm trying to break it, but
done. Oh, what?
Confirmation on the airbase. Reach destination.
Commence the attack. It's time for their wake-up call. The longer it takes, the worse off we'll be. Hurry up. Finish them off.
All right, let's give them a beating.
Target acquired.
Target destroyed.
Spotted. Do you have a visual on him? there now.
Enemy numbers are small. Don't give in. Fight until the very end.
We need to work together to take them down.
One second, folks.
Joke. Roger that.
Strider 1, this is Basilisk. The runway is clear. You have permission to land. The party is on as soon as you get here. Reduce your speed. 3,000 meters to the runway. Turn right. Lower your nose. You're too high. 1,500 meters to the runway.
Nice.
Strider 1 has landed. Let's go and meet him.
Strider 1, you have passed through waypoint 1. No weapons until you reach the enemy base.
Excellent work on the night raid. Submarines have arrived from the Ocean mainland and are refueling. This base will serve as a frontline platform for our mission to take Farbanti. We're almost at the...
Mihai's second sortie was designed to calculate how his physiology changed under the stress of combat. My job was to compare his performance as a pilot now to when he was younger, and understand how his skills evolved. To tell you the truth, I'm not sure I wanted to know the answers anymore. For a man his age, Mihai's body was unbelievably resilient, remarkably flexible. His reflexes were as sharp as they ever were. Still, after all those years of flying in the outer layers of the atmosphere, even someone as strong as Mihai wasn't immune to the effects of the strain. The human body is fragile. It was not meant to handle the excessive amounts of radiation that constantly bombarded the stratosphere. For Mihai's second sortie, we used a flight suit that was still untested. He seemed fine on takeoff.
Yeah, you can have it.
By the time he landed back at the base, it's clearly a mess. He got caught in a surprise dogfight with an especially stubborn enemy. It took a while for Mihai to bring him down. The suit was ineffective. According to the data, it wouldn't let him fly to his full potential. A new flight suit was made to my exact specifications. When it finally arrived, Mihai's granddaughters glared at me with their disapproval. They blamed me for the pain their grandfather had to keep enduring. But Mihai remained stoic. He wasn't the type of man who cared about anything that happened here on the ground. I wasn't worried about it. I was confident the new suit would protect him thoroughly so that he could maneuver his plane any way he wanted. The moment he took off in his new flight suit, I realized what I had failed to before. Right after takeoff, as the wheels retracted, the plane suddenly arced up. It accelerated so quickly. I had never seen a plane move like that before. Mihai hit the high G's multiple times before disappearing into the blue. The support team couldn't even keep up. And then I knew. I understood why he never seemed to care about restoring his stolen country back to its former glory, and why he didn't seem to care about anything that happened here on the ground.
It's good.
Yeah. Of course. Mihai's kingdom was the sky.
Ice cream makes it better.
Thank you.
operation to capture Arusha's capital, Farbanti, is beginning. This is the culmination of our work. We need to capture the Arusian forces' general headquarters in the south of Farbanti and end this war. The plan is for ground troops to attack Farbanti from both the east and north, and a task fleet will attack from the southwest. We will secure air superiority over the capital while providing air support for our allies on the ground and in the water as required. By all accounts, we expect this to be an intense, full-scale battle across land, sea, and air. Should you need to replenish your ammunition or make necessary repairs to your craft, a return line has been set up in the north. During this operation, we will also be tasked with having to destroy the communications satellites that Arusha hacked. If we take down the information communication system we believe they have control over, it should plunge Arusha into chaos. Once the capital falls, the Arusian military will be isolated and thrown into chaos, making it easier for us to end the war. However, that can't happen until after the capital falls, so you guys are the stars of this battle. Arusha will fight like a tiger, but we cannot lose. We must seize the capital and end this war.
So close. Okay, I think I'm going to quit for now, but I will be back to play something else in a little short while. We'll see you then. Take care.